Son, and Holy Spirit.
Blessed be God's kingdom, now and forever.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Watch and be ready, for you do not know on what day your Lord is coming. Let us pray. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Darkness, not light, as if someone fled from a lion and was met by a bear, or went into the house and rested a hand against the wall and was bitten by a snake. Is not the day of the Lord darkness, not light, and gloom with no brightness in it? I hate, I despise your festivals, and I take no delight in your solemn assemblies. Even though you offer me burnt offerings and grain offerings, I will not accept them. And the offerings of well-being of your fatted animals I will not look upon. Take away from me the noise of your songs. I will not listen to the melody of your harps. But let justice roll down like waters, and righteousness like an ever-flowing stream. Hear the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Psalm is Psalm 70. O God, be pleased to deliver me. O Lord, make haste to help me.
Let them be put to shame and confounded to see my life. Let them be turned back in disgrace.
Let them turn away for shame, who say to me, aha, aha.
Let all who see you be joyful in the land because of you. Let those who love your salvations say always, God is great.
As for me, I am poor and needy. O God, be swift to save me.
You are my helper and my deliverer. O Lord, make no delay.
A reading from the first letter of Paul to the Thessalonians, chapter 4, verses 9 to 18. Now, concerning love of the brothers and sisters, you do not need to have anyone write to you, for you yourselves have been taught by God to love one another. And indeed, you do love all the brothers and sisters throughout Macedonia, but we urge you, beloved, to do so more and more, to aspire to live quietly, to mind your own affairs, and to work with your hands as we have directed you, so that you may behave properly towards outsiders and be dependent on no one. But we do not want you to be uninformed, brothers and sisters, about those who have died, so that you may not grieve as others who have no hope. For since we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, through Jesus, God will bring with him those who have died. For this we declare to you by the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will by no means precede those who have died. For the Lord himself, with a cry of command, with the archangel's call, and with the sound of God's trumpet, will descend from heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up in the clouds, together with them to meet the Lord in the air. And so we will be with the Lord forever. Therefore, encourage one another with these words. Hear the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus said, the kingdom of heaven will be like this. 10 bridesmaids took their lamps and went to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish and 5 were wise. When the foolish took their lamps, They took no oil with them, but the wise took flasks of oil with their lamps. As the bridegroom was delayed, all of them became drowsy and slept. But at midnight there was a shout, "Look, here is the bridegroom. Come out to meet him." Then all those bridesmaids got up and trimmed their lamps. The foolish said to the wise, "Give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out." But the wise replied, "No, there will not be enough for you and for us. You had better go to the dealers and buy some for yourselves." And when they went to buy it, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready went with him into the wedding banquet, and the door was shut. Later, the other bridesmaids came also, saying, "Lord, Lord, open to us." But he replied, "Truly, I tell you, I do not know you. Keep awake, therefore, for you know neither the day nor the hour." For the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. One thing I forgot to do is to thank all of those ladies who put the cross together, beautifully decorated with poppies. Thank you to all of you who were involved in that. Well, as we draw nearer the end of the year, our lectionary readings start to focus on the theme of the end, in Greek, the eschaton, especially chapters 24 and 25 of Matthew's Gospel. To put today's gospel in its context, we need to understand Jewish marriage customs at the time of Jesus. Before the marriage itself, there were a series of joyful processions. Usually the festivities took place at the home of the groom's parents. The young women would gather at the place of the wedding, and they would then await the arrival of the bridegroom, which is, of course, the opposite of today, where the groom and his party arrive first and then wait for the bride to arrive. These women have all brought their lamps. Some have brought extra oil along, while the other half didn't, which meant that they had to go out and look for more when they ran out. But while they were gone, the bridegroom arrived. The parable ends with a warning: keep awake, which can also mean be watchful, be on the alert. God's timing may not be the same as ours. Be ready for the unexpected. We run our lives according to certain schedules and timetables. This year, particularly with the pandemic and in the beginning of the year, around about March, when the lockdown happened, a lot of us were spending a lot more time at home. And many people were starting to work from home because of the pandemic. And one of the pieces of advice that was going around at that time was, whatever you do, maintain a schedule, maintain a structure, a routine. Make the bed. Don't loll about in your pajamas all day. Get dressed, clean your teeth, do all the things that you normally do to provide that sense of structure. And for many people that's difficult, because some like to jump into a structure that has already been set. Others like to set structures and schedules not only for themselves, but also for others. Some of our schedules are set for us by others. Others we set ourselves. But God's timetable, God's schedule, and ours are not always in sync. Be ready for God's arrival in our lives at any moment, because it may come without warning. The five bridesmaids who didn't bring enough oil for their lamps were called foolish because they weren't prepared. Be prepared, the motto of the Scouts movement. It could be a warning, be prepared. Danger ahead. I always feel disappointed when in the summertime I see the sign stingers at the beach, a warning that if you venture into the water, you run the risk of being stung by blue bottles. Other signs like sharks or beach not protected or enter at own risk are all warnings for us to be prepared. Today's parable can be read that way. Christians, stay away. Keep alert. As a child, I remember a very fiery evangelist coming to visit the church and preached a sermon on being ready for the coming of the Lord. And I remember him asking a question, if Jesus came back today, where would he find you? Would you be ready? And of course, he was trying to scare us not to be caught in some place of ill repute or caught doing what we shouldn't be doing. By the way, my immature, childish mind worked at such a young age. I went through a short period of time when I would rush in and out of the toilet because I didn't want to spend too long in there in case Jesus came while I was there. How embarrassing for that to happen. Well, is that the thrust of this parable? Be prepared, be on the watch because God might jump you at any moment. The early Christians believed the return of Jesus was imminent. They believed it would happen within their lifetime. But of course, it turned out not to be so. We've been waiting over 2,000 years. That's a long time to keep alert, isn't it? For one thing, we're not made that way. We're not made to be in a state of heightened anticipation and alertness. It's exhausting. I've known people who have had a dramatic religious experience, a life-changing encounter, a genuine one with Jesus. But before long, it wears off, and they start to worry and try to sort of fan the flames and keep it alive, thinking, well, maybe this wasn't real. Maybe my faith isn't genuine. When I'm preparing young couples for marriage, invariably, they believe that they will, particularly their young couples, if they will remain perpetually in the first flushes of romantic love. Over time, and it's very difficult to tell them when they're younger, but over time, love changes. It becomes more stable. Moonlight and roses becomes daylight and dishes. while the early heat of romantic attraction may wane, their love will grow deeper and more profound. But you can't tell them that because they're in a different stage of life. You can only say, well, that's how it's going to be. And of course, those of you who've been married a long time can testify to that. In our faith journey, we may go through phases where we feel very little. We may be tempted to think it's all up to us. That saying, it's not about you, is pertinent here to apply in our relationship with God, which is not ultimately up to us. It's up to God. Remember, this parable is about the arrival of the bridegroom. All the 10 bridesmaids had to do was to be ready. We are here in church today, not because we're better than others. We don't come here to sort of congratulate ourselves, pat ourselves on the back, and say, well, we're here because God has come to us first in Jesus Christ. God took the initiative in becoming incarnate in Jesus Christ. And then in baptism, adopting us as members of his family and citizens of his kingdom. God calls us to serve that kingdom and gives us what we need to be faithful. So this parable can be read also as a promise. The reign of God is yet to come in its completeness. God may come swooping into your life when you least expect it, like the bridegroom who suddenly arrived late at night. God may seem far away from you sometimes, maybe right now, but God will come. Are we ready? Are we prepared? Your relationship with God, your worship of God, your service in the church, your living the Christian life, your involvement in the mission of the church, none of that is about you. It's not up to you. The man said, "I feel like I've been preparing for this all my life." His beloved father had just died of a massive coronary. How had he been preparing for this all his life? He said, all that sitting in church, listening to sermons, reading the Bible, all of that was getting me ready for the worst day of my life. It was like disaster training. Now, the disaster has come. It has hit. And I'm reaching down. I am praying that I pay attention, that I will be fully prepared. And I reflected on the way different people handle crisis and disaster. Some are just blown away by it. Their world collapses. They're unprepared. They've neglected their training, if you like. You think of what you're doing here today on Sundays as a disaster training session. At times, it may seem mundane, even boring. Our culture doesn't teach us to be patient. We have to be on the go all the time. One of the great Christian virtues is patience. God doesn't work according to your timetable or my timetable. But I find that frustrating at times. I've heard people complain that they get nothing out of being in church down through the years. And I feel like saying, it's not about you. We have to keep at it. Be prepared. Be alert. And God will come to us. When night is darkest, at midnight the bridegroom arrives. That's when waiting is hardest. Much safer and more comfortable to be at home in bed. To give up waiting. But then God comes. Take this parable as a warning. And take this parable as a promise. Let us together affirm the faith of the Church. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pray for the world and for the church. Loving God, we recognize our responsibility to encourage and uphold one another and to live together in peace and love. We also recognize our needs and our human weaknesses, and come to you now with our prayers and petitions. Lord, in your mercy. Holy God, we pray for church leaders, that they will be guided in their ministry by the influence of the Holy Spirit, and that the church, in the power of the Spirit, may make the gospel understandable to people of every race, language, and culture. That the Holy Spirit of peace may unite and reconcile the peoples and nations of the earth, bringing an end to war, hatred, and discrimination. Lord, in your mercy. Creator God, we pray for your world, of which your Son is King. We pray for peace, reconciliation, and healing in the places of war, hatred, and terrorism. We pray that the leaders of the nations of this world may be united and subject to the rule of Christ the King, through whom and for whom all things were created. Lord, in your mercy. Mighty God, we commend to your gracious care and keeping all the men and women who serve in the Navy, the Army, or the Air Force, at home and abroad. Defend all who face danger and put their lives at risk, so that others might live in safety and give them the courage to face the perils of active service. Comfort all worried families whose loved ones are in danger. Surround them with your love, protect them from all harm, and help them to know that nothing can separate them from your love. Lord, in your mercy. Gracious God, we pray for medics and chaplains and all who support the suffering. Give them wisdom and skill, sympathy and patience to minister to the sick and wounded, and to all prisoners and captives. We especially pray for all who return from the field of combat with injuries, both physical and mental, that have ruined their young lives. We pray for those on our parish list of the sick and others known to us. Lord, in your mercy. Loving God, we pray for those who go down to the sea in ships and occupy their business in great waters, that they may be aware of your love for them in all that they do, and bring them safely to their home port to your glory. Lord, in your mercy. Merciful God, we pray for those who have given their lives in battle. We remember too all civilians and non-combatants who died in the fighting. Surround all who are bereaved with compassion and give them a patient faith in their suffering. Lord, in your mercy. Everlasting God, wash away the wounds of war, violence, and hatred. Help us to recognize how blessed are the peacemakers, and to know that if we really wish for a peaceful world, we should honestly pray, "Let it begin with me." Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our
Almighty God, you have promised to hear our prayers. Grant that what we have asked in faith, we may by your grace receive, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. If my people who are called by my name humble themselves, pray, seek my face, and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and heal their land. Let us therefore confess our brokenness, confident in God's power and promise to make us whole. Heavenly Father, you have loved us with an everlasting love, but we have broken your holy laws and have left undone what we ought to have done. we are sorry for our sins and turn away from them. For the sake of your Son who died for us, forgive us, cleanse us, and change us. By your Holy Spirit, enable us to live for you. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. May Almighty God have mercy on you, forgive you your sins, and keep you in life eternal. Amen. We are the body of Christ.
His Spirit is with us.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have these gifts to share. This bread will become for us the bread of life. This wine, the cup of eternal salvation. This money and food, symbols of our life, our labour and our love, transformed by your grace to bring you glory. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have these items of knitted headwear, and these personal items to be used. We pray that they may be a reminder to those who use them of the love of the parishioners of this parish. Blessed be God forever. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We give thanks to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
All glory and honour, thanks and praise be yours now and always. Lord of every time and place, God beyond our dreaming, We give you thanks that from the beginning of time, your Spirit has brooded over this ancient land. In the fullness of time, you revealed your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ, who by the power of your Spirit was born of Mary and lived as one of us. By his death on the cross and rising to new life, he offered the one true sacrifice for sin and obtained an eternal deliverance for his people. We give you thanks that in him you have revealed to us your presence in the vastness of this land, your love in its fruitfulness, and your purpose in its cycles of death and renewed life. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and singing. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me."
Let us proclaim the mystery of faith.
A As our Saviour Christ has taught us, we are confident to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. We who are many are one body.
For your sharing in the one bread.
Thank you. Bring your reconciliation to others, and be a sign of your wholeness in this broken world. Most loving God, you send us into the world you love. Give us grace to go thankfully and with courage in the power of your Spirit. They shall grow not old as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them.
We will remember them,
lest we forget.
Lest we forget.
Thank you.
pray for the defence forces. Eternal God, the only source of peace, we pray for all who serve in the defence forces of this land. Give them courage and comfort in danger, patience in waiting, and discipline in the just use of force. Help us to seek for all people the freedom to serve you and each other in compassion and peace. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Not being able to sing the national anthem, we'll just listen to a sung version of it. Baptism, you have given us an inheritance into one family. Give us grace to walk together in the unity of Christ Jesus, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in the peace of Christ.